Good morning, everyone. Happy New Year. Hope this new year will bring a better way out for all of us. For the past 1 year that we are going through, especially kids who are missing out on the school, the everyday happiness of meeting their friends. So hopefully this year, we will be able to end that and then move on with our normal lives. So with that hope, I am wishing you a happy new year ahead and a healthy and prosperous new year ahead. So today we will look into the final part of our adolescent series, where in the previous episode, we have looked at, how the teenagers or adolescents are vulnerable for a number of conditions. And we have discussed on two important conditions. Those who have followed the previous episode in part two, we have discussed on the conduct disorders and also the self-harm behavior in the young people. So today in this last episode, we will look at two more important conditions, severe mental disorders and how the separation or divorce of parents can affect the young adult. And then we will briefly close the session by looking at what are the situations that are helpful for effective counseling, especially when you are seeking counseling services for the adolescent. There are some specific conditions, both for the parents as well as the adolescents who are willing to take the counseling services. So with that, we will complete the adolescent series. So like we were discussing in the previous episode, that in spite of most of the adolescent group pass through this phase happily, there is a small group of adolescents or young people who are especially vulnerable for these conditions. So looking at severe mental disorders. So what are these severe mental disorders? So there are situations where the young people feel depressed or alone, or people cry and then feel miserable, don't want to talk to anyone, don't want to interact with anyone. So these are all usually considered as the growing up problems of adolescents, and most of them can be resolved with the help of family and friends. But there is this small set of group, usually 1 in 5 kind of people, young kids, where they might get into severe mental disorders. So when we call the mental disorders, can be emotional, sexual, and behavioral problems, where they usually lasting longer, more than 5 to 6 months, and then having long-term effects on the career as well as academic area of these young people. So generally the mental disorders, we call them mental disorders. Some of them like childhood autism, they might start in the childhood and then affect the developmental period, affecting the young adult in their language as well as communication and social interactions. There are conditions like hyperactivity, where they have difficulty in concentration and having difficulties in controlling their impulsive behaviors, and then moving on to adolescent might pose more difficulties in adjustment. So there are certain conditions that develop in or start in adolescence, like conditions like schizophrenia, where there might be a hereditary vulnerability, where the condition is considered to be more severe in conditions like schizophrenia, where the adolescent might come up with unusual fears of someone following them or observing them or controlling their thoughts, or someone is arranging cameras, or someone is, you know, mixing some harmful medicine or poison in their food. Some such thoughts will bother them, and they are very distressing for these young people. So generally, these conditions are considered to be having a high family vulnerability. And there are other conditions where most of the adults, like we have discussed in our psychoeducation series, the anxieties, depressions, all the conditions the adolescent are vulnerable for. So looking at how we can kind of what happens when the adolescent have these severe psychological problems or psychiatric problems, generally there might be difficulties in their behavior, in the way that they kind of interact with the family members. And sometimes they might become a little more unmanageable and a little violent, where it can disturb the family situation in a much more intense way. So here there are, family members who are the take care, the caretakers are affected, a sense of feeling guilty and unable to help their kids, you know, is will make the parents more guilt prone, and then it can become a little more disturbed kind of family environment. So looking at what might be the reasons, like I said, there can be the childhood origin, or sometimes a disturbed family environment, disturbed relationships between the adult family members, and a continuously high noise level at home. And then when there are critical issues, unresolved critical issues, ongoing issues that are a continuous stress, not only to the adults, but also to the teenagers. And as we have discussed in the developmental, psychological development of these youngsters who are having changes in their body, changes in their psychological health, and their way of looking at things from their own perspective, all these can actually intensify the disturbance, not only with the youngsters, but also the whole family environment. So how do we handle such conditions? What is it that the parents or the caretakers need to do? So immediately, when there are initial symptoms, it is important that the parents should look for an immediate help, because when it is a short-term kind of, like there are only a few months that the child is into this disturbance, and especially if it is a first episode, that can be completely taken care by effective professional help. Especially the medical psychiatric help is required here. Unless they are really unmanageable, most of these young kids can be treated with the medications and counseling help, and on an outpatient basis, unless they are really manageable and aggressive, usually it requires a little more intensive kind of help, most of them can be treated in outpatient. And then the medication plays a very important role here. When they are going through these psychiatric kind of symptoms, like I have described a short while ago, all these kind of thinking disturbances or distortions are basically because of the biochemical changes that are happening and neurochemical changes that are happening in the brain, and psychologically, or sometimes living in a kind of unhealthy kind of community also can be contributing to these kind of situations. So effective and at the earliest, taking professional help. Some of the conditions need intensive psychiatric help, and some of the conditions need both counseling as well as the psychiatric services. And if the help is not given at the earliest, it can be a lifelong condition, disturbing the child's progress in the academics. If they are into a career, affecting their career choices as well as their personal life. So this is in brief about what is a severe psychological condition or severe mental disorders. The second condition of the topic today is how the separation or divorce of the parents can affect an young adult or an adolescent in particular. So when it comes to with the increased rate of separation of the couples, even in their late 40s and 50s, is at an alarming rate, is a cause for concern. And then the teenagers who are witnessing these kind of situations feel that they might get into a kind of self-blame, that they are responsible for this split up, especially if there are problems related to their behavior or related to their academic or career related or behavior related kind of temperament related kind of issues. And then they might feel guilty, blame themselves, and feel abnormal that they are living in a very unhealthy kind of a family situation. And they might start becoming more aggressive, or they might start showing and acting out kind of behaviors. And some of the kids might actually become more regressed into a babyish kind of behaviors, get back to their kind of childhood kind of behaviors that is holding the attention of the parents, and then trying to keep the parents together as a attention seeking. And the adolescent, each adolescent will respond in their own right. So we can't always say that all adolescents respond to this kind of situations in the same way. But definitely there is a sense of being in an abnormal family, sense of being kind of guilty or a kind of helplessness that bothers these youngsters. And then they can start affecting their growth in more in terms of their social interactions, as well as their career and academic areas, and then their interaction with the peer group. And all these things can happen when they are witnessing a kind of separation, especially if the teenager is being kind of supposed to produce some witness or evidence against one of the parent, and then they have to choose one parent over the other. It can be really miserable for them to go through this, and can become very traumatic for them. So it is more a kind of lack of control over the situations happening. And then it's important that the adolescent need to be kind of given a chance to talk or listen to their views. So here the parents, mainly in order to minimize the trauma that happens, it's important that they have to communicate to the teenager or the young adult that it is their own decision, and then it is not because of the adolescent or the person's behavior or their behavior. And then the parents has to take that complete responsibility of their decision to move on or separate. And then it is important that they need to be available for the teenager. There should be a kind of open communication with the parent to the teenager, and also the kind of providing a kind of secure environment that their needs will be taken care, and then they will be given a continuous support in spite of not being able to be together. So this is the situation of if very few teenagers might actually have mixed feelings or might feel relieved if there are marital discord, high noise level, or a kind of violent environment, where especially in a situations like alcoholism, that kind of situations where one of the parent is not very effectively contributing, and then there is a dysfunctional kind of a situation, they might actually feel relieved, or some teenagers might end up having some mixed kind of feelings. So it is the open communication and their parental kind of reassurance that they will be available, and then they can meet their other parent whenever there is a need that they want to kind of see the parent or talk to the other parent. And then it is a kind of a little troublesome and miserable situation for the teenager that they had to choose one parent over the other, and they usually long for a normal situation that they live together again. So it is important, and it is the parent who has to make sure that they are not affected, especially their future is not affected because they have taken this decision, and it is important to communicate this to the teenager. So looking at the situation where when the parents are looking for a professional help, be it counseling or psychiatric help, it's important that they discuss with their children before they actually bring to the counseling situation. So usually when kids are brought to us, they are usually resistant to cooperate because they come with a feeling or they have been forced into a situation where what parents want to explain them, whether they are trying to explain it through a third person, is not a very comfortable situation for an adult or an adolescent. So it's important that the parents well prepare and then be honest with them that because they are unable to handle the situation, that they need to take help, and it is for both of them, both for the parents as well as for the teenagers, to figure out what is healthy. And then they're well prepared before bringing to the counseling situation, which is a very important aspect. And then even for the psychologist or the psychiatrist, gaining the trust of the teenager is a task. So since they come with a feeling of resistance, and trust building is a very important aspect, and the it needs a specialized kind of expertise in dealing with the teenagers' problems. And it's important that an enough time is taken, a good rapport is built. So it's important for the parents to understand this aspect. And it is not that the counselor is doing the job for them, that they want to convey something and that they want to, kind of communicate through the counselor. So it is important that they are prepared well, and then not only the teenager, even the family members, the parents are involved in the therapy sessions, family therapy sessions, as well as individualized sessions need to be looked into, and then it needs a little more intensive and long term, especially if there are issues related to the kind of aggression or problems related to marital discord. Most of the emotional issues or the behavior problems in teenagers are because of the marital discord that is happening with the parents, and their inability to maintain a calm and healthy environment is most of the teenagers are getting into these kind of disturbed kind of situations. So this is about how both severe mental disorders as well as the diverse, which is imminent, and then that they have taken a decision and how they have to help their teenagers in order to kind of take things in a much more controlled way and in much more kind of safe and well prepared. So I once again wish all of you a happy new year, and hoping that we will enter into back to our normal situation and then be able to lead a normal, healthy lives. Thank you all.